Yes.
Yeah, that's a good story.
Yes, yes.
When you're ready.
I'm good. Thank you.
As I said before, my parents sometime had work permit, so they didn't have to hide and didn't have to hide me. Eventually, they lost that work permit, but at that time, they already managed to smuggle me out of ghetto. But there was a young girl who was born in ghetto. And in memory of that horrible place, she was named Gitella. Her parents didn't have work permit, and of course, grandparents didn't have work permit. So they were hiding behind false wall in their room. You know, in each room live number of families, but to their luck, all people who live in that room supported each other. So whenever Germans were searching ghetto, they managed to hide behind that wall with that girl, Gitella. At one point, when Germans were searching that apartment and she began to cry, her grandfather covered her mouth with his mouth and was breathing, give her a little bit of air, so no one would hear their cry, her child cry. So later, I don't know how and where, they managed to get some kind of anesthetic. I don't know what it is, but for a few days, they kept her under that medication, which you will go under soon, but you cannot be endlessly anesthetized. And in that condition, almost dying from being so long unconscious, they managed to bring her somehow to Alexander Zhivetsky. That girl really needed medical attention, far beyond what Alexander could provide in her house. So they develop strategy. They make from rugs doll, wrapped her with a blanket, and brought to City Hall and made statement that this child is definitely sick. We don't want even to touch her, for she is so wrapped around. But as any human being, she deserves to have a name to bearing under a real name. So no one wanted to touch and look on that baby, and they gave them birth certificate. I don't know what name, but in any case, they gave birth certificate. Having document, birth certificate, they managed legally put her in the hospital. And she was taken care of, and she survived. And Pani Alexandra, or Lady Alexandra, took care of her till end of the war. Her parents survived, so when city was liberated, they came to, took her, and they moved to Israel.
Ready? Last part? It's a little bit...